السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Blessings to all of you. So when we look to ourselves, which is the main thing that we should do, looking to ourselves doesn't mean that we just ask ourselves how I feel, what I want, what are my fears, what are my complaints. That is not looking to yourself. Yeah. That is a reaction on the condition you have, but this is not yourself. That is what we call the veil. That there are the veils, many, many, many veils. In the tradition, we say there are 70,000 veils that veil us from ourselves. So looking to the veils doesn't mean that you see yourself. Yeah. That means simply that you resonate in that moment with the veil that resonates with you. So, for example, someone passes by, looks at you and say, "Oh, you're looking very tired." Yeah. Then in that moment you will resonate with that comment. Yeah. You don't have to, but mostly it is like this. And that resonance will be probably not a high one. It will be like that you say, "Oh, this person said to me this. Am I looking tired? Is it like this, you know?" Or you will get angry. You know, why that person says this and so on. So we are all the time in resonance with each other. But this is not how you know yourself. Yeah. It is good to see, of course, what resonates. But being in this business of looking at your veils, what will prevent that is that you start to act. Yeah. And acting is the only thing that really brings you further, that improves your life. Yeah. When you start to stop permanently seeing yourself in all kinds of resonances, yeah, with everyone around you, with everything, you become a leaf in the wind. And if you are lucky, you come to good places. If you're not lucky, you will be permanently inside of you in a traumatic situation. No? So this reason why, for example, in our tradition we have what is called Qibla, that is the direction where we pray. Now you ask yourself why we should have a direction. No? If Allah is omnipresent, yeah, if the divine is everywhere, now why? What does it make? What sense it makes to have one direction? Yeah, that is a mystery. If you ask many people, many Muslims, why do you pray in that direction? They will say, "Yeah, because Allah said it." Yeah, the Prophet did it like this, so we follow. Yeah, that is not a bad thing, because you may not know, but you have a trust. However, if your whole life is just based on that, that you follow someone that you trust, again, you will not know yourself. Yeah. You will be in good hands if it's a good person. So you will have a kind of protection, but you will not know yourself. Yeah. You will live morally a good life, but you will not necessarily live a life that connects you. So knowing the things you do, if you want to know yourself, is elementary. Yeah. It is not enough to just follow. Yeah. It is very much needed that you understand what you are doing on every point of your life. Yeah. And this understanding you can only understand when you look at your actions. Yeah. Not your resonances, not your feelings, not your thoughts. You have to understand your actions, because the actions is what is just there. It's not anything that you can speculate about it or that you have to speculate. The action speaks louder than words. Yeah. Now, there is this saying, the hadith, that says, and we will be not judged by our actions, but by our intentions. Yes, but that is the mercy of God. But if you want to understand yourself, you may know your intentions, but I want to risk to say not many people know their real intentions. Yeah, there's so many layers of intentions. Most people think they have good intentions, but their actions show they are not. They don't have them. Yeah. We all have good intentions in our world, right? I don't think that anyone has really a bad intention, or if so, there are very few ones. But our actions show a complete different picture. Yeah. They are not fitting with our intentions. They're not really corresponding. They're not coherent. No. So first, look to correct the actions. Then you may understand your intentions. And in the best scenario, you can bring them together in the root. You align all them, your thoughts, your emotions, and your intentions, your actions. Yeah? You align them. You align them, and then you will be living a magic life. Right. So that's why it is so difficult to communicate, because people look at their intentions, they look at their way they think, and so they say, I'm a good person. Yeah. And they blend out completely that they do almost the opposite of what they actually intend or what they think they are. Yeah. And this is the reason why we have corruption. This is the reason why we have gossiping, why we have betrayal, why we behave as we behave. Yeah. So you want to know yourself, then just look in your daily life. Look, what is your action there? Yeah. Make a video on it. Yeah. And then look, what is it what you spend, how you spend your life? No? And that will count. No? What you do, that will count. And it is the action that gives you satisfaction. Yeah, it's in the world inside, right? Yeah. It is a combination of action and becoming satisfied. This is satisfaction, right? So it is through the action that you find satisfaction, you know? And when you do the things right, your emotional system, your thoughts will follow eventually. Because you cannot go straight, do things straight, and think permanently crooked. Yeah. It will come out in your actions sooner or later, right? And this is what you see, for example, then in institutions like the Catholic Church. Yeah. It's their actions that reveal, yeah, on a certain point. And some things they did good, but some things they did so bad that there is no description for it, right? And their intention as an institution is certainly good. There's no doubt about that. Yeah, it's written in all their books, it's written in all their scriptures. But their actions reveal what is really happening within you. Yeah. The same is with the speaking. On a certain point, things will come out, because it is like, you must think it like a pressure pot. Yeah. On the first level, you will, if you really watch your thoughts, you will see what you think. Most people cannot do that. Yeah. Second, you watch your words, what comes out. And it's not only what you say, it's also how you say it. Yeah. Very important, no? Because communication is a rhythm of silence and of words. Yeah. And the way you speak, the way you say things, they create a different way of silence. Yeah. They can be a tense silence, they can be a peaceful silence. It depends very much what you say and how you say it. Yes? So when we say mastering your tongue, mastering what comes out is only possible if you understand things. Otherwise it pops out. It will come out one way or the other. But if you want to know where a person is, you look at the actions. Yeah. You look at the speech. And if this somehow is coherent, if there is not an extreme difference, no, then you can say this is an authentic person, this is probably a very true person. Now, that has not necessarily to be what we call a good person. You see, sometimes so-called bad people are more authentic than the so-called good ones. Modern often used to say, I like angry people. Yeah. Because an angry person doesn't try to show something. When someone is in anger, the anger is always true, right? They said, at least we know where that person is. When he's angry, you know exactly, okay, this is where that person is. Yeah. So anger is not only a negative thing. Yeah. It becomes negative when it is unconscious in you, when it is dominating you, when it wants to hit others and you hurt others. In that moment, all those emotions, when we start to create trouble for others, then it becomes a difficult thing. So acting is first, because it is the body. Yeah? And this we need to understand, that the hierarchy is first in our body. This is the most strong identification we have. And there we need to do the best. That is the most difficult, is how we act in our physical reality. Yeah? How we behave, how we walk, how we eat, how we talk, and so on and so on. It's all there. That is our visit card, no? This is what, if someone watches us, he sees first this, right? So getting the control over your physical moves, over your physical appearance, no? Being clean, being in a kind of good shape, yeah, is important, right? Because that is your visit card. That is the, I don't know, that's your business card, not visit, visit card is German. That's your business card, right? That's the thing you show. Yeah. So, if you want to show a good one, then, you know, you have to dress in a certain way, you have to behave in a certain way. If you say, I don't care if people don't like me, you know, the way I am, well, it's their business, yeah. That's not a very wise thing to do, yeah. So, advice is not to be all the time looking, how am I? No, am I like this? Am I like this? But what I should do? What is the next step to do? And the next step is not like tomorrow. The next step is what is the next, literally the next. Yeah. And Muhyiddin Imam Arabi, one of the greatest Sufi masters, he said a very nice thing. And this was, do the necessary and try the impossible. Yeah. So it means first duties. Do the necessary, pay your rent, pay your taxes, pay whatever there is to do. Yeah. Go shopping, make your life working. Yeah. Do the work that gives you your income and so on and so on. Yeah. So these things are first. Make your daily life first. Yeah. And in the daily life, you integrate a practicing. No? That practicing will help you not to forget for what were you really here. Right? So, practicing, meditation, prayers, whatever that means for you, something that goes beyond just the senses, just the way we are here, and goes beyond. No, it looks beyond time, you can say. No, it looks towards eternity. Manala loved the word eternity. Sometimes he just repeated it, eternity, eternity. He loved it. Yeah. Because eternity is something which connects us to the next station we all will enter. And this is when we pass away from this world. Then we go to a dimension where time does not exist in the way it exists now for us. Yeah. One part of it, it's eternal. Yeah. So, look what is the action that you need to do, and then go with it with full trust and find satisfaction, be satisfied the way you act. Thank you very much. May Allah bless you all, and good new year for those we didn't mention yet. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.